The Divine Finalisation, Prologue. The prologue is a summary of the events in the Divine Sedition. In the year 2872, Keila Eisenstein, a young Martian rebel with supernatural visions and premonitions, is on the run from the evil dictatorship that is ruling the entire solar system with an iron hand. The Terran Council, consisting of the mightiest houses of planet Earth. Being pursued by her nemesis, Rear Admiral Bjorn Muller, Keila manages to escape and crashes down on the asteroid Eden, home of her deceased mother. There, she comes across an artificial Bronze Age society dominated by the malevolent God-King Abraham Goldstein. Keila slaughters Abraham and befriends Metatron, one of his angel super soldiers, and tricks Bjorn Muller into abandoning his pursuit of her by faking her own death. Once Bjorn Muller has left Eden, Keila and her ally Metatron are in control of Eden. They decide to modernize the Bronze Age Edenite society so that they can use Eden as a base of operations to stage covert operations against their Terran Council enemies. The killing of Abraham Goldstein by Keila Eisenstein and modernization of Eden faces a slight problem. However, it angers Adina, the granddaughter of the late Abraham Goldstein. As High Priestess of Eden, she uses her psionic abilities with Zetan mind control technology to endure and hurt both Metatron and Keila. They both survive Adina's psionic attacks, and in the process, Keila prevails as she forces Adina out of Eden's hidden tunnels, where she is incinerated by orbital laser cannons and dies. After securing her leadership on Eden, Keila seeks for ways to fight the Terran Council, and she finds using Eden's ancient secret technologies to travel to the Divine Dimension, where Zetan civilization sought refuge after their home planet Zetani was destroyed by the Xeno alien race. In the Divine Dimension, she receives knowledge of Zetan advanced alien technologies hidden in the abandoned Zetan archives for millennia. With these newfound technologies, Keila is convinced that she can win a future Martian war of independence against the Terran oppressors. But to be able to mass-produce the Zetan technologies for planetary war against Terran Council, Keila needs the help of scientists to reverse-engineer the Zetan alien technologies for mass production for her people of Eden. An opportunity to acquire scientists presents itself when Marcus Bauer, a prominent Terran Council scientist, offers to defect to her side on the condition that she helps him escape from the Proxima Thule research station where he is located. Metatron fears a trap, but Keila's visions tell her to trust Marcus Bauer. Using her Zetan alien technologies, she defeats the Terran enemies in Proxima Thule swiftly and covertly, bringing back the much-needed scientists to Eden as recruits. Back on Earth, the chairman of the Terran Council and father of Rear Admiral Bjorn Muller, Joachim Muller, is angry with his son for Bjorn's lack of progress. To punish Bjorn, Joachim Muller puts him under the command of the sex-starved genetic mutant, daughter of House White faction leader, Alicia White, and sends the duo on a mission to find out who attacked Proxima Thule and to investigate the rumors about Keila being still alive. Bjorn Muller, Alicia White, and her black operations team travel to Eden to investigate on rumors of Keila Eisenstein's sudden appearance. Alicia White felt instant sexual deprivation towards Metatron, and they cannot find Keila Eisenstein, as she took off before they arrived. A while later, Alicia got frenzied from drugs and had ravaging, ghastly sex with Bjorn Muller, and almost ends up killing him. This causes a massive diplomatic crisis between House Muller and House White. Alicia and her group go into hiding to avoid punishment. A couple of months later, Marcus Bauer, who defected to Kayla's side, has a scientific breakthrough and manages to reverse engineer the Zetan technology so that they can be mass-produced for war with human technology. At the same time, Keila finds out that she's pregnant with Metatron, which is an inconvenience for her revolutionary plans. Keila has a vision indicating that she's meant to give birth in 2 years, so she opts to have an embryo removal and put the fetus in suspended animation for future use. Metatron, upset that Keila took this decision without his knowledge, ends their romantic relationship, but they remain amicable, sharing the power of Eden. Keila then uses another Zetan technology, the Zetan external DNA modifier, to alter her appearance and DNA signature. She travels incognito to Mars to meet with Hellas Petrarchus, the president of the prominent Martian nation, the Olympus Republic, to discuss a revolution against the Terran overlords. On the way to Mars, the passenger spaceship that Keila is traveling on is attacked by the infamous space pirate Morgan Henry. Keila is petrified with fear when Rangda is offering to help her in exchange for temporary control of her body. Possessed by Rangda, Keila butchers Morgan's crew and finishes off Morgan Henry by tearing out his heart and eating it. Keila sustains injuries during the altercation, but they were only superficial. She lands at the interplanetary passenger terminal in the Olympus Republic and is promptly arrested by local police for questioning. Meanwhile, Bjorn Muller has arrived with his forces to investigate the pirate attack and the mysterious women that killed all the pirates. After analyzing bloody bandages in the medical room, Bjorn makes the terrifying realization that the mystery woman in fact is his nemesis, Keila Eisenstein. Since Bjorn was the one who declared her death a year earlier, he destroys the evidence of Kayla's resurgence to save his own image. At the Olympus Republic, Keila manages to convince President Hellas Petrarchus that she is Keila Eisenstein despite her altered appearance. They agree to share battle plans and technology. Keila goes back to Eden to bring more Zetan divine technology and her personal strike force. Before she leaves, she inserts a lower tier mind control technology into Hellas' brain so that they can communicate without risking the Terrans intercept the signal. After that, Bjorn Muller arrives at the Olympus Republic asking Hellas Petrarchus for information about the mysterious woman that killed Morgan Henry, which Bjorn knows is Keila. Hellas denies any knowledge and Bjorn doesn't want to press the issue as he doesn't want the truth to come out. Hellas then sets Bjorn up with Martian prostitutes and secretly films it to have a leverage against House Muller. The next few months, Keila, influenced by Rangda's evil genius, performs covert attacks on different Terran Council members' installation and make it look like other members did it, effectively to cause the Terran Council member to fight among themselves and to weaken their hold of the solar system. Eventually, Keila leads a successful attack on the gadolinium mines at the Tengel Dominion on Mars, prompting her first major victory. House White responds by a widespread orbital bombardment of Martian settlements, furthering the resentment for the Terran Council among the Martian population. A while later, Keila launches coordinated surprise attacks on the Terran Council bases on Mars. The Terran Council defenders are utterly unprepared for the alien Zetan technologies and are defeated. Keila is unfortunately wounded in the battle and must sit out the final battle taking place later the same day, the attack on the Terran Council's Phobos base. Under Keila's order, a huge wave of Martian populations led by Melchior Dorevitch is heading for Phobos. Bjorn Muller won't let them conquer the base. Instead, he's redirecting the fusion thrusters on Phobos' moon base, setting it on a collision course with Mars. On impact, this would melt the surface of both Phobos and Mars, killing everyone in an instant. Keila wakes up on the surface and sees what is happening in a vision. Despite her injuries, she sets out to stop her nemesis, and she faces him near the thrusters of Phobos. Bjorn shoots her twice and leaves her for dead. And then he takes off in his spaceship. Keila doesn't die from her wounds, however, as the divine intervention from the True Maker temporarily heals her wounds and grants her enough strength to change the direction of Phobos' fusion thrusters to direct the moon onto a collision course with the sun instead. She sets after Bjorn and they both crash down on the surface of Mars, on top of Olympus Mons, mountain of Olympus Republic. Bjorn gets out of his spaceship severely wounded and is shocked to see Keila, whom he thought he killed moments earlier. Keila states that Bjorn is under arrest for his crimes, and Bjorn asks her what the point of that would be, since they're both dying in the wilderness. Shocked, Keila drops to the ground with her previous wounds coming back. Bjorn then professes his everlasting unrequited love for Keila, but she is cold towards him and calls him out for kidnapping and forcing her into becoming his sex slave, causing her to become a Martian rebel. Feeling hurt and heartbroken, Bjorn throws himself off the Olympus Mons cliff edge, killing himself and making sure his body is too severely damaged to be regenerated. A few days later, Keila is recovering from her wounds and gives a speech where she declares Martian independence. She hopes that she will be able to negotiate a peace treaty with the Terran Council, as the Terran Council is in no position to invade Mars anymore, having lost their Martian headquarters. The Terran Council led by Joachim Muller has other plans, though. With the defeat against the Martians and the declaration of Martian independence, the Terran Council members finally stand united and are ready to strike back. As they have lost Phobos' moon base, Joachim Muller now orders to redirect a giant asteroid B600 to a collision course with Mars. The Terran Council sends a black operations team to the rogue asteroid B600. The mission is so secret, Joachim won't even let his own brother, Supreme Commander Matthias Muller, in on the plan. Instead, he lies to Matthias, commanding his fleet to protect the giant asteroid from Martian interference, when in fact he's planning for a collision. Knowing that Matthias Muller is a reasonable man, Keila sends a delegation to negotiate with Matthias directly. But during the negotiation, an agent controlled by Joachim assassinates Matthias and makes it look like the Martians were behind the murder. Running out of options, Keila desperately asks Rangda for guidance. Rangda tells Keila to use the Zetan technology to change appearance to that of Alicia White and then travel to Earth to open portals hidden in pyramids scattered around the planet. Keila, posing as Alicia White, is questioned in immigration by the high-ranking Terran officer Hilda Muller, where they both drink wine and she receives clearance for entry to Earth. Keila then sets off to activate the portals in the pyramids, but nothing seems to happen. and eventually she's arrested for vandalism by House Rashid security forces. This is a blessing in disguise. As the Rashid guards are fooled, as she has the altered appearance of the prominent mutant Alicia White, they then take her to the gathered conference of the Terran Council that occurs in the Rashid city of Rashidium for her immediate sentencing of causing vandalism. Meanwhile, Hilda Muller is meeting up with Marcus White, telling him about her drinking incident with his cousin Alicia. Marcus exposes that Alicia must be an imposter, as the real Alicia White is lethally allergic to alcohol and only drink real blood. They rush to the meeting to stop the imposter, Keila Eisenstein. Keila posing as Alicia White is finally surrounded by all Terran House faction leaders. She then uses this golden opportunity to massacre her enemies by releasing a nerve agent that she had hidden in a fake tooth, killing everyone instantly in a toxic biochemical blast. With the Terran Council leadership dead, she then orders the asteroid B600 to be diverted towards a collision with the Sun. Keila, in all her victories, then watches the most beautiful sunset behind the distant glowing pyramids, feeling at peace with her impending death. Just in time before this story ends, Keila suddenly observes a luminous spark of blue lasers and beams as the portal to the divine dimension magnificently opens at the tops of the Cheops pyramid.
Instantly swarms a massive horde of Xeno aliens, which hungrily butcher and eat the unprepared Rashid security forces, releasing their alien powers and beast-like hunger of flesh. Suddenly, Keila stands face to face with Rangda, the evil Xeno Zetan hybrid queen, the demon she had only seen in her visions. Rangda knocks Keila unconscious with a sonic blast and carries her back to the portal to travel back to the divine dimension.